Thank you. Christ.
Oh. My brother Ben likes to make jokes.
Bertie Hare, brother's wife's the only one of us from a hardcore family. They once owned a blind plantation.
They're called Lionel. You may have heard of it, sir.
No.
Fine cotton land and simple means. Would you mind if you partners be in trading for me? And I'd be hip aristocracy.
Mr. Hunter, you want to know here. Why you want it here is not my affair.
So bring the machine to the cotton, not the cotton to the machine. Bring the machine to the cotton, not the cotton to the machine.
I just want to make money.
Marshal, Marshal, Mr. Marshal.
Hobbit sons of Marshal now.
Hobbit sons of Marshal.
Yeah, you must speak to me.
Christina.
To drink, I closed my eyes, and then I saw those bricks come into the rise.
So, and I'm more than that. Bernie and I have just been planning for the road. I know when I go, all the time you won't take some of the chickens in the
road. Caution, don't count the chickens. Well, maybe God would allow a little dream. I think I'll ever stay.
The Spartan Kings,
why the Spartan Harbor, why not?
No, 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 no. Now that you think it's Oscar, what did you
mean? The pleasure of seeing the bricks rise, and then I take a few little tricks. Ha! Birdie, what do you say?
Thank you.
believe you can even get Horace to come home.
Oh, I can get him home all right.
How?
You'll see. But before Horace comes home, I want to know, what's he going to get?
What do you want?
You want to see, you'll be seen. Imagine, not wanting to go to Baltimore. wish it were me.
I can just guess the kind of things that you'd do.
Oh, no, you couldn't.
You're
Oh, my God, what do you want to be?
Yes, Leo, if you had the bonds, you'd be rich, too. You don't suppose your uncle Horace will lend them to you?
Papa, you sure you'd be all right? My God, lend them to me?
No, I don't guess he'd lend you the bonds. You'd have a share, a big one, too. No, I'm not silent, they ought to do. Sometimes you gotta look out for yourself. You say he don't ever look in the box. If he don't look, he won't ever miss him.
And it won't hurt him.
No, it would not. It wouldn't hurt him at all. You see, remember the cigar, son? Leo, do you gather what I am talking about?
Sir, I don't think so, sir.
I begot me a fool.
Thank you. I see anyone, why did Zan come to fetch me home?
All I know is big things is going on. Everybody gonna be high on rich. You too.
I've heard about that.
And the well. Zan, she gonna marry Leo in a little while.
What are you talking about?
That's the talk. God help us. There ain't gonna be a wedding, all right. Over my dead body days.
Go and tell him I'm home. Go on, Addie.
Miss Regina, you're home. We got you.
Hello. Hello, Oscar. Leo, how are you?
Answer, my love, better now that you're back.
Is it safe to have a
Well, it's just as if I'd never been away. All of you here. Wait, no one can go home. Let us go now. Why should we hide and argue? upset you. I thought it only fair to tell you.
What do the doctors think caused your bad heart? Could it have been your fancy women
that caused my heart to be bad? You don't catch heart trouble in bed.
No, but you might catch a bad conscience in bed.
I didn't tell them about my bad conscience or about my fancy woman. Nor did I tell them that my wife hasn't wanted me in bed for, how long is it, Bridget? Did you bring me home to make me feel guilty again? To talk to you. Regina, I am very tired.
Please, listen to me now. You will see everything has got to be settled. Now, tell Horace all about it. Will he be quick? He's very tired, and he must dress for the party. Can I get you something?
Some water, please.
Oh, I'm sorry. Let me.
It could wait.
Everything's got to be settled. You've been just as anxious as I've been for Horace to get here.
Well, I suppose I have. And why not? Horace has done Hubbard Sons many a good turn. Now, why shouldn't I want to help him now?
Help him? Help him when you need him, you mean.
Well, you know how much a marshal come to Chicago. You wrote all this in your letter. Well, sounds like a good deal for you, boy.
For us, too?
Us? You and me? I don't think so. Oh, we'll just sit by and let the boys grow rich. How's everything at the bank, Jill?
Fine, sir, just fine.
How are all the ladies in Mobile? Whatever made you think I let Sam marry?
Oh,
Mary.
Thank you. the bus in the morning?
Yes, sir. First thing.
Thank you.
Papa, you promised you wouldn't come down.
My dear sir, should you be up and around so soon?
Oh, it's much better, really. Aren't you?
Marshal, do the women in Chicago order their men folk about?
Oh, yes. That's universal, I guess. And a pleasure when it's such beautiful women.
My wife is beautiful, isn't she?
Chicago would be at her feet.
Oh, pretty beauty is so successful everywhere.
Refreshments, everybody!
Are you sure Leo can pull this thing off?
Of course you can.
Leo, you better go right now.
Yes, sir. Would you like me to do
just it? Go.
Yes, sir.
Well, that's that.
I hope so. Don't say something nice to Bertie. Come on, be nice to him.
Hello, Bertie. Bertie, I told you once before.
Oscar, please.
Behave yourself and don't drink anymore. Remember last time.
Miss Bertie, ma'am.
Who's there? Oh, Ivy.
Yes.
Oh,
very well about what?
I don't seem to have changed my mind about anything.
I can remember the time when all I had to do was ask for something and I'd get it.
That's right, it's all fixed. Marshall has his money.
How can he have?
They don't need
you. You hate to think everybody is not. You hate to think
Oh,
Have you got Thank you. It so they can't stop you. Take her away from here. Pretty soon there'll be no one but you to help her. You'll go, Addie?
Yes, I promise.
Let's go inside. I'm having a new will made up. I always wanted to leave you something for yourself.
Oh, a colored woman like me in a white man's will, I'd never get it no how, Mr. Ross.
I know. In the armoire drawer upstairs, there's $1,700 bills. It's in an envelope with your name on it. It's for you.
$1,700? God, Mr. Hoss, I won't know how to count up that high. Oh, it's mighty kind and good of you. I don't know what to say for thanks.
Don't take that box away, Addie. I want it left there, right where Mr. Manders put it this morning, understand?
Yes, sir. I just...
That's all right.
We had agreed you would stay in your part of the house and I in mine. I'll get Cal to take you upstairs.
Regina, do you understand what happened here last night?
I think so.
Go and look in that safe deposit box there. Go on. I had $88,000 worth of bonds in that box. They are not there now.
What are you talking about?
We have invested our money in Hubbard Sons and Marshall after all.
When did you change your mind?
I didn't. It was invested for us. Those bonds are like money.
What kind of joke are you playing now?
I sent for the box this morning. The bonds were gone. $88,000 gone.
Where did they go to?
They're with Mr. Marshall, I should guess. Leo took the bonds.
I don't believe it.
That fine gentleman who nearly married your daughter took the key, opened the box, and stole it. Last night, during the party, he stole them for Oscar and for Ben, of course, too. That's why Ben was so happy.
Oh, what fools they are! This will make a fine story.
Wouldn't it?
To hold over their heads.
Regina. I'm not going to hold it over their heads. I'm going to let them keep the bonds as a loan from you.
What? Oh, no, you won't. I'll do something about that.
You won't do anything, because you can't. I shall simply say we lent them the bonds.
You would do that?
In my new will, I am leaving you just those bonds and nothing else. Nothing more you can do. I'm sick of you. I'm sick of this house. I'm sick of my whole life here. And I am sick of your promise, the small dirty tricks to make a dime. It's about time you were stopped. It's about time. Oh, you're at the town, you and your brothers. You're at the town and live. From the very first, Why did you marry me?
Thank you. Peter said you stop that screaming noise. Mr. Haas, he had a tap of his bad.
Uncle Horace, what? But wait. Oh, you seen Mr. Ben and Mr. Oscar? Answer me, will ya?
No, I ain't seen them. I ain't got no time now.
But what's the matter with him?
Where is he?
Kelger said it was a sudden attack, and I don't know
where. Where is he? When did it happen?
Upstairs. I just found out.
You think we should go up?
I don't know.
But he was all right.
What's that?
What's what? Oh, my
is
God!
Is it?
You ask! Put it down and touch it again!
Is that the same box?
Of course it's the same box.
That box! Then he knows better!
Shut up! Thinking.
You're thinking? I do the dirty work and come in here and then you say...
I remember that, Leo. Huh. Did he tell Regina? That's what I want to know.
Well, sure. He would have told her everything. Yeah. What are we doing?
What happened?
He's had a bad attack.
Well, how is he? Can we go up?
He's not conscious.
It's that bad. Where's Dr. Sloan? Can't he be found quickly? Just once?
I don't think there's much for him to do.
Oh, don't say that. He's come through attacks before. You don't feel well.
No, I don't. Horace told me about the bonds this afternoon.
What do you mean? What bonds?
Oh, you mean Horace's bonds? His Union Pacific bonds?
Yes.
Well, what about them?
He said that Leo had stolen the bonds and given them to you.
Oh, that's ridiculous, Regina! Absolutely. I don't know what you're talking about! What would I do with any bonds?
Please, give it enough that he stole them from me! Do I have to listen to this in the bargain?
You are talking! Mean anything? I don't know what you're talking about!
Will you tell them to stop that, please?
We're starting in the wrong end, Regina. What did Horace tell you?
That Leo had stolen the bond.
I didn't hear it!
Then he said he was going to pretend he had lent the bonds to you. As a gift from me to my brothers. There was nothing I could do about it. So you see, I'm very badly off.
Well, you shouldn't feel that way about it. It can all be explained and adjusted. This is
bad. Oh, then you admit the bonds were stolen.
I do no such thing. Or maybe Horace made up that story today. To punish you. Yeah, punish you. We'll have all this out at a more appropriate time. I think maybe we better go and see if we can't get Dr. Morris.
Huh? I think you better stay and sit down.
We'll be back soon with Dr. Morris. Now, don't you worry.
You will come back in this room and sit down. I have something more to say to you. Come back, Oscar. You call Leo.
Since when do I take orders from you?
The greeting.
little stiff. And the things you're thinking of, tell your guidance star up above you. No one will ever love you, you great eagle.
I'm smiling, Ben.
You put Oscar and Leo in jail?
Listen to him, Oscar. He's getting ready to swear it was you and Leo. Oh, don't be angry, Oscar. I'm gonna see to it that he goes in with you.
Try anything you like, Regina. Horace, lend us those bonds, do you hear me? You learn to make threats and you carry them through. We'll say goodbye now.
Alexandra! My God!
I didn't know.
Who could have known? I didn't know he was that sick. Well,
that seems like yesterday when he first came here.
Yes, that's true. How the whole town loved, respected him.
Thank you. House has ever known you well enough, Regina.
Are you gonna let her do this?
You have a suggestion?
No, he hasn't. Now, Leon, I've forgotten everything. You can draw up the papers tomorrow. You're a good loser, Ben. I like that.
Well, I ask myself, what good would it do to get mad up and tear my hair? You and I, sour people like Oscar Land. We don't end up friends as you, but we got good digestions too. If I lose my shirt, then I lose my shirt. Staircase anyway. Well, a smile is answer to question. That's just my good digestion.
See you tomorrow, Regina.
Oh, yes, certainly. You'll be sort of working for me now.
Alexandra, you are turning out to be a right interesting girl. Well, good night.
I know. like to sleep in my room tonight.
It is a new day.